Say cheese! In this tutorial, if you please, I'm going to show you how to fold this seamless cheese. And if you don't like cheese, then please, how about a golden slice from my rainbow pie? Or how about a point from a rainbow star, which you can use as your avatar? Or a pretty path that grows? Hey look, there's stairs! Okay, enough of this silly prose. Ready, set, here goes. Alright, so for this delicious chunk of Swiss cheese, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of kami. But you could use a sheet of printer paper cut square. So begin with either side up, and we're going to divide into thirds. Now this is kind of tricky. Don't make any folds, just bend one side in front and the other side behind. And now fiddle with the folds until the thirds are exact. So you just want to nudge the layers back and forth until it lines up here and here. And when it lines up perfectly, make a pinch. And do the same thing on this end. Nudge, nudge, nudge. And pinch. And now unfold and fold these two corners to these two pinch marks. And unfold, rotate, and fold to the crease. All right, now comes a fun but kind of tricky step. We're going to decide the shape of this triangle. So what we're going to do is take this corner and place it onto this edge somewhere in the middle third. So bring it up, don't make a fold, just place it onto the edge somewhere along here. And now just hold it in place and take this corner and bring it to the same spot, but slide it up a little further, like that. And this can go up here or somewhere between there and there. I'm gonna make it right there. And now let go of this point. And you could just make a pinch mark here, but I'm going to make a dot just for clarity. And now we have to try to grab this point. So hold the paper here and grab onto it right here and make a cone with this being the top of the cone. So open it out like this and we have a cone right here. Now fold right along this edge from the top of the cone down to the dot. Now look inside the cone. We have this interior flap. We're going to flatten it, but first you want to line these two edges up. So they're aligned and now crease this sharply and uncrease it and rotate. So we have this fold. Now bring this corner to this point. Don't make the fold. Just bring it like that, hold it. And now this is going to be the top of the cone. So make the cone. There's the top of the cone and we're going to fold from tip of the cone to here. Like that, look inside the cone and flatten the interior flap. Make sure that these align. And unfold this flap and fold this flap. Now, fold this flap up so that we're making the fold right on this point where these two creases intersect. And we want this to align. And make the fold. And unfold, rotate, and repeat on this side. So bring the edge up and where these two creases intersect, make the fold. And unfold. So here we have our point. We want to copy it right onto this side. So let's bring the edge up, align corner to corner, And again, you could make a crease mark, but I'm going to make a dot just for clarity. And now fold from that dot to this intersection point. It helps to have your hand behind to provide support. So like that. And from the dot to this intersection point. Okay, now we're going to make a cone by bringing these two creases together. So it's like that. There's the cone. Look inside the cone. Make sure that the edges align right there. And flatten the interior flap. And now make the cone with these two creases. And flatten the interior flap. Okay, now fold this edge over to the crease. Like that. And make this fold and fold it over like this. And now fold this flap over to this side. So it's like that. And now we're going to fold this flap inside. So looking at it like this, we're folding the flap over the edge, over the edges. And make sure that it's even. Okay, and we're almost done. And now unfold this flap and bring these flaps together like this and like this. So it takes the shape of our cheese, and wrap this flap over. And even like this, it makes a nice little cheese gift box, kind of like a lunch bag. It opens like this and you can put your little gift inside there and close it back up. And to make it a little bit nicer, fold this edge to there and then fold over again. That just makes it look a little bit nicer and it closes this edge. But we want to make a seamless cheese, so unfold this flap and insert it into this pocket right there. Goes in like that and all the way in. Just kind of shove it in. But don't make any extra creases or else it won't be seamless. Okay, so there it is. Voila. And it's a cheese slide. And if you fold a whole bunch of cheese or wedges, pie slices, you can see how tall you can balance your cheese tower. This is about to fall. Ah! So there you have it. Another game you can play, as you saw in the intro, is you can try to make a path. So you first put one like this, and then put the next one like this. Now, if your triangles are uneven like mine, then you want to make sure that the longer side, the larger side, is facing the first wedge. That way, it'll fall onto that wedge. So it's like that. And so you just look for the larger side and make that balance. And you want it to just barely lean so that it doesn't put too much weight on this first wedge. Because that's what will happen. So The trick is you have to try to do it without putting any weight. One more. And now very quickly remove the first triangle. And there's the staircase. Ooh, I smell cheese. I love cheese. Yum, 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 yum. More cheese?